We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Today in this lecture, we are going to study about one important law of the optics, where the phenomenon of refraction of light has been studied by Snell, and the law is known as Snell's law for refraction of light. So first of all, we will understand what is the refraction phenomenon, or we will recall it as we have discussed earlier in our lecture. In this particular article, we are going to see about the statement of Snell's law, and we will prove the statement according to one simple observation. So basically, the refraction is when the light is traveling from one medium to another, or they interact between the surface of two medium connections, then there is a chance of either reflection or refraction. If there is a reflection, then the light will travel back towards the same medium, and if there is a case of refraction, the light will travel to another medium and we will observe some bending of it. Most of the time in the glass filled up with water, you may have experienced the pencil example, when you substitute a pencil or pen inside the glass full of water, then you will observe that the pencil has slightly bent. That phenomenon you will observe, and that is due to the bending of light which is traveling from one medium to another. And this particular bending of light, which was passes from air to water, which was determined by Snell's law. And the well-known example is of pencil in a glass of water. So this bending of light is nothing but the refraction. This law also applies to the bending of light by lenses, no matter it is either convex or concave lenses, and to the guiding of light by the fiber optic cables that carry modern communications. So here, the only not two mediums, you can also consider the bending of light by lenses, because glass lens can also be considered as a medium, and hence it is further utilized in fiber optic cables. So more detail, we will observe a ray of light which is passing from one medium to another, say from air to water, is bent or refracted from its original path according to Snell's law. So this is the statement of Snell's law, which you have to remember and also have to mention in your answer sheet. So when a ray of light is passing from one medium to another, medium means what? As I told you an example of glass of water and pencil, the top portion of the pencil is in the medium of air, where the bottommost and some middle portion of the pencil will be reflected inside the medium of water. So this way, we can say the light has been traveled from one medium to another, so there will be a short bending of light rays inside the another medium. So the ratio of c, which is the speed of light in a vacuum, and its value is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, to v, which is the speed of light in a medium, and is called index of refraction, that is refractive index of the medium, which is denoted by small n. So this is again very important physical parameter or optical parameter, which has been used for many cases, and it determines the optical properties in terms of refractive index. So here in this figure we can see the interface between two media, where medium 1 is of air and medium 2 is of water, where this is the tangential line which can be considered as normal surface, and with which the interaction between the input light rays and output light rays in the other medium can be considered. The angle of incidence for the light waves in medium 1 having the refractive index n1 is theta 1, and the angle of incidence for light rays in medium 2 having refractive index n2 is theta 2. So here, as we have observed, according to Snell's law, the mathematical expression can be given as n1 sin theta 1 is equal to n2 sin theta 2. So theta 1 is the angle of incidence, theta 2 is the angle of refraction. So this Snell's law is nothing but the correlation between the incident angle and refraction angle, where two mediums have been aligned towards the interface and this normal surface have been introduced in terms of the light rays. So here, suppose you are considering this medium as of air and this medium as of water, you can see the slight bending. If it was linear, then it would be go through like this in a linear motion, but it has been diverted from its original path, and the main reason is the change in the refractive index of this medium too. So this way, according to Snell's law, the motion of light rays can be affected when the medium has been altered. So some well-known examples of various mediums and their refractive indices have been reported in this table. The vacuum medium is exhibiting the refractive index of 1, which is of vacuum, pure vacuum, of air, that is 1.000293. Refractive index for water is 1.333. Refractive index for carbon tetrafluoride is 1.461. And that for diamond is 2.419. So here you can directly consider the relationship between the density of the medium and the refractive indices of the medium. See, in a pure vacuum, which has almost negligible density having refractive index 1, with increase in the density, because in the air some gaseous molecules will be there, and due to the density of such molecules, this refractive index is also increased. For water, again the density is greater than that of air, so refractive index is again increased. If we continue the process up to diamond, the highest density, so here we have also observed the highest amount of refractive index. So when you consider this figure, you are observing the refraction of light phenomenon. So what are the properties which have been affected? So all these parameters we have to consider. N1 is the refractive index of medium 1, N2 is the refractive index of medium 2. The sine wave function has been utilized, and that is due to the angle of refraction, or the refraction point is considered at normal to the surface, and that is the main reason why we have utilized the sinusoidal wave function. This interface between two media has an important functionality for this particular refraction, as it diverts medium 1 from medium 2. theta 1 is, as I mentioned earlier, is your angle of incidence. Theta 2 is the angle of refraction. So this was all about the properties of Snell's law and its proof. So this way we can easily understand the refraction of light phenomenon. Remember, you all have to mention this particular statement, this figure with its explanation, this particular equation, and you have to mention the interpretation of all these parameters. As I told you and mentioned earlier, this is just for your reference, but you have to be prepared that the refractive indices value for any of this particular medium can be asked in your short question. And the statement and proof of this very important optical theory, which is well known Snell's law for refraction of light, can be asked in 4 marks. You all have to draw neat and clean diagram with proper nomenclature. None of this should be omitted in the figure. You all have to be prepared, and so you will be able to get full marks in your GTU examination. So this was all about the Snell's law for refraction of light, and I hope that you all are aware with the refraction phenomenon between two mediums, between two different non-identical mediums. In the same medium, you can see the light is passing linearly with the same angle, and hence for Snell's law the basic requirement is two non-identical mediums, and hence we can easily consider the refraction phenomenon. So with this article is over, and if you have any queries, you can post in the comment section. So thanks for visiting this lecture.